really has been magical. He's a magical guy, and I mean, he single-handedly has made all of my dreams come true. He's very sensitive, and he doesn't like to make mistakes, but he's a very happy horse, an ears up kind of guy, and he's just fun to hang out with.
When Laura was just 15, her partnership with Verdades began. Together, they have seen nearly a decade of top-level sport.
I've had him since he was a foal, and we've done everything together. I've broken myself, and of course, I've had help and trainers along the way. But I've been his primary caregiver and rider through his entire life. Our big breakout year was 2014, when we were named to the US team for the World Equestrian Games in Normandy, France.
Tonight, the combination that scored 74.8 in the Grand Prix and came 8th in the special on 77.1, Laura Graves and Verdades.
And that was full power. Took a few meters to balance the amount of power, but that was full risk, full attack, which personally I feel at the beginning part of this test was slightly lacking. But she's certainly got there now. And this is another new discovery to the top of the international dressage sport. This combination horse and rider. Fabulous harmony and ease of movement. And there's Robert Dover, the team manager, who's put so much work and support into pulling this squad together. And this combination have just impressed us all the time. And I'm sure are going to be even more of a threat and closer to the podiums as we get nearer to Rio.
With a final score of 84%, the duo broke the 80% barrier after only 2 years of competing internationally together, securing 8th individually and 4th in the team competition. 7 months later, they were back on the international stage again, competing at their first ever FEI World Cup final in Las Vegas.
Their average score in the North American League, just under 80%. They won 2 World Cup qualifiers at Wellington in Florida, where they are based. And Laura would have, when you look at her record, not only limited international experience with this horse, but also very, very limited indoor freestyle experience. Audience quite rightly behind that extension. It's just super. Yeah, a lot of riders, you know, would come down on an extension like that into Canterpirouette. Laura takes the risk somewhat of riding straight down that center line, but shows great straightness. We've already seen the one tempi's on the curving line now, straight and again showing the horse's straightness. A huge reaction here in the Thomas and Mack for Laura Graves and Verdades as they complete their Grand Prix freestyle.
With a total score of 79.125%, they secured 4th place, narrowly missing out on the medals. 2017 saw Laura and Verdades set their sights on a podium finish. With a home crowd behind them and a new freestyle, it looked like the stars were aligning for the FEI World Cup Finals in Omaha.
I always ride to win. So whether it's a qualifier or it is the World Cup, I'm riding at 100%. And it has a high degree of difficulty. Hopefully we can pull that off. We've been working very closely on the music with Terry Gallo, my trainer Debbie McDonald. And you know, this whole event is about the freestyle for us. And so hopefully it's a crowd pleaser.
This is certainly amongst one of the most significant challenges to Isabel Wirth for these finals. Laura Graves and Verdades for the United States of America. Individually fourth at the Olympic Games, she wants to step up onto that podium. And if she can score the 85% that gave her fourth at Rio, she is going to lay down a serious gauntlet here in Omaha.
The degree of suppleness with this horse always is impressive. You really see clear bending in the half passes, both at the passage half pass and the trot half passes.
Laura stood individual silver at the Toronto Pan American Games, two teammates, Steph Peters.
After a very strong start here. I know that Laura has made some small tweaks to her music throughout the season just to try and perfect this as much as possible and for this event. So two tempies on a curved line immediately into one tempies. Again, very high degree of difficulty and performed beautifully. Is going to be more than happy with this performance.
Out of the passage, she pushes the throttles forward into extended trot down to her final halt and salute. She can do no more, but it looks like she's done an awful, awful lot. Laura Graves and Verdades for the United States of America.
With a score of 85.307%, Laura was second only to the queen of dressage herself, Isabel Wirth.
Never actually been on a podium before as an individual, so this was very special, and of course Isabel knows how to make it a party.
Fast forward a year and Laura was ready to fight for the top spot for the FEI World Cup Finals in Paris.
You know, I think we both came into some of our first internationals not knowing what to expect. We were not prepared to really swim with the big fish, and we were very naive going out there and obviously having some top finishes. But now a little bit that's expected of us. And I expect it of myself, and he is also a fierce competitor. I mean, he doesn't do anything for less than 100%. We're prepared to win, and we know actually that's a possibility.
Laura and Verdades entered as one of the favorites, showing that they meant business in the Grand Prix.
Lovely changes. That's what we were saying earlier about them traveling and using the whole diagonal. So much power. Oh, he was ready to halt a bit early.
Good boy. Laura Graves and Verdades leading the American charge and charging into the lead here in Paris. No doubt about it. The question is merely what the score will be. Can she put so much pressure on Isabel tomorrow that the finals could go the way of the United States of America? 81.413, that's the first time she's broken 80% in Europe outside of Wellington, Florida. 81.4 is the Grand Prix score. It is, I think, a new Grand Prix personal best as well for Laura Graves and Verdades.
Finally securing a first-place finish in the Grand Prix, topping her rival Isabel Wirth, all she had to do was repeat the feat for the freestyle.
yeah, it was all business, but it was actually very fun. Super, super pleased with my test. It was extremely clean, and the judges agree it was a personal best, and not a better time for that to happen. So we certainly are not taking this for granted, and it's a nice support behind us going into tomorrow's final. But she is very, very difficult to beat in the freestyle, and I don't expect the same mistakes she had today to happen tomorrow.
So next to go, winner of yesterday's Grand Prix, the world number 5 ranked combination, the biggest competitor to Isabel Wirth's 4th World Cup title, Laura Graves and Verdades. Laura, who won 2 World Cup qualifiers and a 5-star freestyle on 84% with this new freestyle at the Adequan Global Dressage Festival in Wellington, Florida this spring, where she was unbeaten. She's the reigning Pan Am Games silver medalist and team gold medalist, a medalist from the Rio Olympic Games when she finished 4th in the freestyle on 85%.
That's a very steep half pass.
The second of 4 double pirouettes in this new freestyle floor plan for Laura Graves has a very, very high degree of difficulty.
Better connection, just a bit of tension there at the end. I mean, that was dinner plate size. More expression in that extended canter. Again, maintaining that activity and bounce.
Yeah, and the change of direction within the Piaf pirouette rather than moving on and starting a whole new one. It's very, very difficult. It's original, but you know, the quality of the underlying technical movement. He was getting good marks yesterday, but you know, the absolute purist will say it is an incredibly active and almost frenetic Piaf. It's not truly correct. It'd be interesting to see where the judges fall today. Laura Graves and Verdades go into the lead on 89.082. A massive new best score for this freestyle for Laura. Artistic marks there right up in the 90 percentages.
Unfortunately, it wasn't to be, as Laura and Verdades were once again beaten by Isabel.
This is an unbelievable experience. I'll remember this one forever. 2 personal bests, an 89% in the freestyle. There's not a lot to complain about here in Paris today. It really fuels my fire for preparation for the next few events and certainly for the World Games.
As the pair approached their second WEG, they had come a long way over the last 4 years.
It's different. Looking back at Normandy 4 years ago, nobody expected very much of us. And now being ranked top 3 in the world, knowing this is probably our last World Games, I really want to deliver a best performance. So it will be a lot of pressure and I'm sure very emotional.
After clinching team silver on home soil with Team USA, Laura and Verdades went on to compete in the Grand Prix Special, trying to win their first world individual medal.
Remember, on 80.4, which is good enough for the lead, of course. But by the same token, Patrick Cattell is on 79.7. He's waiting in the wings to overtake her if there's an error.
You can see the mark went down to a 7.4 for the 1 tempies instead of an 8. Got really good counter pirouette. And quite a good Piaf on the final center line.
Solid hold.
So it's going to go into the lead.
But has she left the door open for others to take the individual medals today? Laura Graves and Verdades will be hard to bet against for the podium in the freestyle.
Securing second in the Grand Prix special and team competition, she was denied the opportunity to show off her freestyle by bad weather.
It's amazing to even have a horse who makes it to one world championship, let alone two. And our first one was our first year doing the Grand Prix. He's now led me to an Olympic medal, two medals here so far. You just can't say enough good things about this horse. He's a horse of a lifetime for this country, I think.
The next big target on the calendar was the FEI World Cup Finals in Gothenburg 2019. Surely she was guaranteed a win.
Laura Graves, it is, ranked second in the FEI World Rankings. She rides at Verdades. This lady is hungry for success.
She revamped her music after the Paris Finals last year in preparation for the World Championships in the America in Tryon earlier last year. However, didn't get to ride it. So let's enjoy it today. Big, beautiful changes into lovely, tidy pirouettes. He is on fire today.
Degree of difficulty has now gone to 94.4. Come on, my bottle of wine. She's coming into land. The lady from the USA. She's ranked second in the FEI World Rankings. Can she make it a win here today and knock the crown from Isabel Vert? Laura Graves has ridden the test that she really wanted. She is hungry for the win here in Gothenburg. All the final collective marks are now in. But we don't have a score. Oh, we do! It is a new leader, 87.179.
In what turned out to be their final appearance on the international stage, they were once again picked to the post by Isabel Verth, with a score difference of only 1.6%.
Obviously, we wanted to win. But what can you say when your horse goes as well as they possibly can, right? It's still winning for him, and that's all that matters.
With an international career having spanned 8 years, Verdades was retired in early 2020, having seen 4 FEI World Cup finals, 2 World Equestrian Games, and 1 Olympic Games. Laura Graves and Verdades have been one of the most successful combinations in US dressage history.